Look at this! Look at this! It's actually fucking working!
Oh my god!
Hey yo, what's fucking good? It's your boy Wolfie, and today, your boy DIY Wolfie is back in his bitch! And today we are gonna be making some glow-in-the-dark slime. So before you go down and chirp me in the comments being like, yo, Wolfie, the slime trend was like over in 2015, bro. People have made like friggin' slime, ooh, black, Orbeez videos like years ago, bro. Like, what are you doing? Well, see, the thing about that is, honestly, I don't give a fuck, okay? I do what I wanna do, and I wanna do it today! So I did some research on how to do the slime videos, cause I have no fucking clue how to make it. And then all of a sudden, I stumbled across a video that said you can make slime from potatoes. There's this guy named Grant Thompson. Apparently, this guy's a fucking magician. This guy made slime out of potatoes. And I happen to have some I have some potatoes in my house. So before we even begin, you guys know I love my likes. And for every DIY video that I do, your boy has horrible luck. So go down, smash that like button right now. I want to hit 200,000 motherfucking likes. If we can hit 200,000 likes, this is gonna work perfectly. And your boy DIY Wolf is gonna be successful. Because honestly, after my last DIY, I need to prove myself. I did a fucking shit job. So I will leave Grant Thompson's link at the top of the description. Shout out to him. Hopefully this experiment actually works for your boy. Because I don't really believe this video. You know, with all the editing and stuff they do these days, I have to try it out myself just to make sure it's an actual thing. So if I fail horribly today, which I'm not going to, because if I were to fail, I would fucking edit it so I look like I didn't fail. So I guess that's it. Let's do it.
You fail every single time.
I never fail.
And you always keep it in the
let's go! So of course, if we're making slime from potatoes, we're gonna need some potatoes! Okay, so the first thing you're gonna do with these potatoes is open your garbage, okay? Fucking toss it out. We do not use yellow potatoes. The yellow potatoes do not work. Fuck the yellow potatoes, okay? So we're just gonna take them out, actually, because I'm gonna eat these for dinner later. So you're actually gonna grab your russet potatoes, okay? These are russet potatoes, or russite. As you can see, everybody knows how to pronounce that. Russite, R-U-S-I-T-E. The reason we are using these potatoes is because these potatoes have the most starch in them. Now, a lot of you guys are like, what the hell is starch, Wolfie? Like, what is starch?
What's starch?
Okay, what's starch? Bless. This is starch. Corn motherfucking starch, okay? You guys might call it corn flour in the United States. In Jamaica, you guys might call it corn starch. Basically, it's this white powder. Well, we gotta open it. So basically, cornstarch is some starch you use when you're baking cupcakes and brownies and stuff. Little thick flour substance-y food. So just, yeah, no fucking clue what this shit is. I may have overestimated a bit because I got like 4 packs of this shit. So I definitely don't need this much, but I always like to overestimate. It's always better to overestimate, like the chef say, than under fucking
shit.
No
chef ever says that.
I also got my food coloring. I got neon food coloring. And last but not least, you are going to need this shit. Tonic water. This is the stuff that's in your parents' house that you're like, why do humans drink this? I have no idea. Every type of soda is better than this shit. I mean, I'll take a sip for you just because. This is basically carbonated water. Why do you need carbonated water? Nobody fucking knows. Fucking delicious. I love this fucking stuff. So let's get started. So the first step is to cut up your potatoes. And everybody knows when you cut up your potatoes, that involves a knife. So when you're cutting them open, you wanna just open them up nice and gently. Let's get these taters out here. And honestly, I know cutting potatoes can be a little bit annoying because it takes so long to cut them to the little cube size that you're gonna want. So there is this little quick trick that I was taught, you know, like I was taught.
Who taught you? Who taught you?
Chefs, what you wanna do is cut the potatoes to the smallest size possible. The smaller you cut them, the more surface area times the volume and the length and width and the height of the volume, you're gonna get the most starch. So cut the smallest pieces you possibly can. This trick is not hard at all. You just wanna take your knife and start cutting like this. God damn, man. Like, see, this shit is just too damn easy. Like, honestly, I took like a 5-minute nap in that time. Like, how did you guys not see me? I was napping. So I hope you guys followed along on how to cut those potatoes up. It's just pretty simple, right? Just math. Okay, bless. But there is an easier way to cut up the potatoes if you don't want to cut them up. We got a grater. Just do a couple of little grates, okay? And honestly, I'm not gonna do the rest because this is the tutorial and I don't need to. So that's the way it's gonna happen. You guys can do it at home. Take your time. Honestly, I'll just wait a sec. All right. You're probably not even close to being done. But it's all good. Next step. You're gonna wanna grab a big bowl. It can be metal, it doesn't need to be metal. I got metal because it's more expensive and I love living lavish, so that's the way it's gonna go. But now you're going to slowly slide all the potatoes into the bowl, and you just don't want to miss the bowl at all. As you guys can see, the bowl is just not getting missed at all. So I may have missed a little piece right here, but other than that, it looks pretty spotless. So next step is to turn the tap on and let it get to the hottest water possible. The hotter the water gets, the more starch comes off of the potatoes. I don't know if that's actually true, I fucking completely bullshitted it, but it sounds right, so I know it's right. Okay, so the water, I'm pretty sure is warm, and to make sure water is the right temperature, you never want to check by putting your hand under and feeling it, because you could burn your fingers that way. And I don't want to promote any violence on this channel, okay? We don't like to do anything dangerous on DIY Wolfie, okay? Nothing dangerous. So nothing dangerous, okay? So what you're gonna want to do is put your hand close to it, and then you want to shove your face into it. That's hot as fuck. Perfect temperature. Fill it up until there is just enough water to cover the potatoes. Then you want to grab your spatula, water bottle, flip it in. Okay. All right. There you go. So we water bottle flip it in and just stir it. Just stir it completely normal, okay? You don't want to do anything troll. So yeah, you just want to keep stirring it until the water becomes nice and brownish red. I'd say about 3 to 4 minutes of stirring is the perfect time before you're done. So because it's been 2 minutes, we're just going to take it out because I don't wait. Grab another bowl. Okay, this is the biggest move. You cannot mess this move up. You want to grab a strainer. Put the strainer over the glass bowl or the plastic bowl. Thought it was glass. It's definitely plastic. And what you are going to do is pour the potatoes into the strainer so that no potatoes actually go into the bowl. Very, very careful. Very careful. Okay, we're just going to scoop out everything here. I don't want to see any comments saying kids in Africa could have eaten those fucking uncooked potato slices, okay? Not one comment. So now we're gonna wait about 5 minutes, and what you are about to see in this bowl is gonna be friggin' magic. How many of you guys wanna see magic? You wanna see magic?
Me.
Okay, bless. One's good enough. If you guys said no at home, we're doing it anyways.
A few moments later.
Okay, so it's been about 5 minutes. What we're gonna do now is lift this up, and you think I would throw this out, but we're not gonna throw this out. We're gonna put it back into here because we're gonna cook hash browns after with this. No wasting. Except for this shit. None of this is getting eaten, okay? Don't even think it's getting eaten. It's not getting eaten. But here's the magic, guys. You thought this was just water, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
water?
Yeah.
Bless, what's this? What is that? Okay, that's definitely not as much as I thought was gonna fucking come out. That looks so wild. This is the starch, guys. So now you're gonna grab a little more water, get the starch going. You're gonna grab a mason jar, and what you're gonna do with the starch, you are going to put it into the mason jar, and don't spill a thing, because you need every little ounce you can get. Okay, now that we got all the starch out of that, we're gonna close the mason jar lid, give it a little shake up, and wait another 5 minutes, okay? Be back in 5. All right, guys, so it's been about 5 minutes, and as you can see, this is what happens. All of the water and all of the dirt and everything has gone to the top of the container, this whole layer. But at the very bottom is all of the starch, okay? So when we open up the container and you pour it out really quickly, all of the starch is stuck to the bottom. It looks kind of like glue. So the problem is you're gonna need a lot more fucking starch than this. You're like, okay, if with that many potatoes, I only get this much starch each time, if I wanted to get like this much starch to make the slime, I would need to grate a lot of fucking potatoes. And that's where you're right. Your boy spent 3 days grating up potatoes and doing the same process I just showed you in order to get this much fucking starch, okay? This is the real deal. This is potato starch. This ain't no corn starch, okay? You can see one is a lot dirtier. This one's got like different layers. This might be fucking rotten, but we're still gonna use it. So yeah, if you just keep doing the same process over and over and over again, the starch is gonna collect on the bottom like this. The water's gonna form up there. All of the dirt and everything is gonna form up here, but I left this in my friggin' room for 3 days. This stuff smells like absolute shit. I'm gonna open it just to make sure the smell's still there.
Mm-mm.
But here we go. All right, I'm throwing this shit out. We don't need that starch, okay? We already collected it. That was just to show you what happens, but this shit is getting thrown out ASAP. So anyways, if you keep doing this, it'll turn into this, and this is what we want. So all I know is if you guys have not smashed the fucking like button right now, go down and hit that like button because your boy spent 4 days doing this DIY. So now the fun part. So now what we wanna do with this is we wanna grab a spoon, and now we're gonna scoop out a few spoonfuls of this. And if I'm right, then this stuff should act exactly like this cornstarch. So the cornstarch way is a lot easier, and obviously I'm gonna show you it after, but your boy Wolfie does not do the easy way out. We're gonna challenge ourselves today. So instead of using cornstarch and water, what we're gonna use is the tonic water, like I said. This stuff is gonna be the key ingredient to make it glow in the dark. And we're just gonna pour a little bit in at a time until we can make it into the slime. We're gonna switch the bowls up because this bowl is absolutely cheesing me with all the ridges. And we're gonna keep mixing it up until it becomes really thick. Ooh, it's becoming a solid. Guys, this might be working. This might be fucking working. Let's go. All right, so we're just about done mixing, and check this out, guys. This is so cool because if it works, it acts as a liquid and a solid. So as you guys can see, it looks like a liquid, okay? It moves like a liquid, right? I'm pushing it, but it's not acting like a liquid. It's acting like a solid. So as you guys can see, if you pick this stuff up quick, you can literally roll it into a ball, as you guys can see, but you let go and it goes instantly into a fucking liquid. Guys, this is literally made from a potato. You move it together really quick, put it into a ball. If you don't stop moving it, it's not gonna lose its shape. But as soon as you stop moving, look at that, guys. It turns into a fucking liquid. That's crazy. If you punch it, it's like I'm punching a solid. There's no liquid getting on me. I can cut down the middle like a solid. Do you see that? Boom, boom. And now for the real test, guys. Check this out. If you spill it on the table, I spilled a liquid, right? Nah, you can clean it up. Boom, put this together really quick. Pick it up like a solid. Solid? Okay, boom, liquid. Bro, where's the mess? So now for the fun part. Is it glow in the dark? I really hope it is, otherwise I flopped. But apparently, the tonic water has something in it called quinine. It's on the front. You guys already know what quinine is. It's basically a chemical compound in the absorbency of the reactors. So this is the thing that's gonna make it glow in the dark. As long as you're using a black light, and I happen to have two black lights. So guys, look at that. That is so fucking dope. What is cooler than glow-in-the-dark slime? Well, I'll fucking tell you. Glow-in-the-dark slime made out of a friggin' potato. You put it together quick, and it does not break apart. But as soon as you let go, look at that. That is fucking dope. Just the tonic water and the black light alone. Look at how fucking dope that is. It's fully glow-in-the-dark. And guys, look at this. When I put my fingers in, if I put them in hard, they won't even sink to the bottom. But if I put them in slow, they sink in just like a liquid. That's fucking crazy. When you lift them out slow, liquids start coming off your fingers. When you try and lift your fingers out fast, it literally like suction cups them. You can't lift them. It's like quicksand. So that was a lot of work. And I know a lot of you guys aren't gonna wanna grate up a billion potatoes. It's gonna take multiple days. So don't worry, I got you guys too. This is so much fucking easier. I don't know why I didn't do this from the start. So just take a bunch of cornstarch in here and water. That's it. Cornstarch and water. Why did I do the complicated way? Nobody friggin' knows. This one is not glow in the dark. But if you wanted to make it glow in the dark, you just put in the tonic water instead of water. So as you guys can see, it's already working and it's way cleaner. There's no potato juices built up from 3 days smelling like shit that are permanently stained in your shirt, permanently stained on your face. But I mean, to each his own. Like sometimes some people like just shit on their face. So as you guys can see, this is a little too liquidy. We want to make it more solid. You can't screw up with this. You just got to keep adding in more water or more cornstarch until it becomes the perfect slime consistency that you want. Okay, so it's just about the thickness we want. Now what we're going to do is we are going to lose our spoon in there every fucking time. We're going to grab our food coloring and we are going to put a bunch of food coloring in to make the slime look cool. However much you think you need, you definitely need more. Every chef always told me that. The reason this is happening is gravity. That's why. So you don't need to ask anyone. It's just gravity. Everyone knows that. So I'm gonna grab a nice ball of this pink. As long as you move it fast, it is not gonna turn into slime. You're like, yo, this is a solid. Yeah? Then what's that? Liquid. That is a liquid. Look at that. I know a lot of you guys are like, yo, this is just amazing to watch at home. It's amazing to feel. I am not getting to the bottom of the bowl. Ah, that mess is gonna be brutal. Is the mess gonna be brutal or is the mess not gonna be brutal? Let me put you into a ball and let me slime you out. And last but not least, when I put my hands into it, it just sinks into it like liquid. Try and pull it out and I take all the slime with me. Anyways, there you guys go. Your own DIY glow-in-the-dark slime made from potatoes, okay? I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please do not forget to go and smash that like button. I spent days preparing this DIY. So let's see if we can hit 200 motherfucking thousand likes. My wolf fam smashed that on every video, and I know you guys love my DIYs, so go smash that like button. Also, I want you guys to comment down below more DIYs or more science experiments that your boy Wolfie can do. Just make sure that they are as easy as this one, okay? Just like maybe mixing 2-3 ingredients together. So comment them down below if you want to see me do them. I am always willing to do ideas for the wolf fam. Other than that, shout out to my girlfriend again for filming. This took way longer than you guys think it took, okay? Go subscribe to her channel, youtube.com/SylviaGanny. Is it going to be at the top of the description as well?
It better be.
No. Yeah, guys, click the link in the top of the description. Go subscribe to my girlfriend and give her mad love in the comments. Tell her King Wolfie sent you. But that is it for today's video. I will see you guys soon with another banger video. And as always, this is fucking another mess I'm gonna have to clean up in my kitchen. Stay savage. Let go. That's fucking crazy. Give me some. Oh.
Whoa.
Yo, look how dope this is, guys. This is amazing. Here we go. Flip it over. And when it slows down is when you really see like every single texture.